Hello all. Welcome to the session on basic operations on signals. When we process a signal, it may undergo several manipulations involving the independent variable or the amplitude of the signal. Some of the basic operations on the signals are amplitude scaling, signal addition or subtraction, signal multiplication, time shifting, time reversal, and time scaling. The first one being amplitude scaling. Amplitude scaling for a continuous time signal can be represented by the equation y of t is equal to ax of t, where x of t is the input signal given and y of t is the output. Here capital letter A is a constant, and depending upon this A, we can determine if the signal is amplified or attenuated. If A is greater than 1, which means that if the constant is positive, amplification is obtained. If A is less than 1, which means it is negative, it is attenuation. Let us look into some of the examples for amplitude scaling. Consider the example of x of t is equal to cos omega t and y of t is equal to 2x of t. Here, the amplitude is scaled by a value of 2. A is equal to 2 in this case. And this is the x of t signal, first one, a sinusoidal signal, is obtained as x of t with an amplitude of 1, because here A is equal to 1 in this case. This y of t will be doubling the amplitude into 2, that is 1 into 2, 2, minus 1 into 2, minus 2. There is an amplified cosine signal is obtained in the case. For a discrete time signal, the equation may be changed as y of n is equal to ax of n, where small letter a is the constant for determining if it is amplification or attenuation. Going into the example, y of n is equal to 0.5 x of n. Here, the value of a is equal to 0.5, which means that it is less than 1. As a result, attenuation is caused in this case. The x of n signal is given here, the discrete time x of n signal. When n is equal to minus 2, it is 4. N is equal to minus 1, it is 2. N is equal to 0, it is 4. And n is equal to 1, 2. With n is equal to 2, 4. This x of n signal is amplitude scaled by a value of 0.5 and an attenuated signal with n is equal to minus 2 position 2, n is equal to minus 1 position 1, n is equal to 0, 2, n is equal to 1, 1, n is equal to 2, 2 is obtained as a result. These amplitudes are reduced. The third example being y of n is equal to minus 3 of x of n. In this case, the x of n signal is given as this. This is our example. When minus 2, n is equal to minus 2, the value of x of n is 2. When n is equal to minus 1, x of n is 1. N is equal to 0, x of n is 1. N is equal to 1, x of n is minus 1. And when n is equal to 2, x of n is 2. As the amplitude A is equal to minus 3, it is also attenuated case. The amplitude is reduced. At the position of 2, we have, at the position of minus 2, the amplitude 2 will be changed to minus 6. At the position of 1, minus 1, here we have 1, it will be changed to minus 3. At the position of 0, where the amplitude is 1, it is multiplied by minus 3 and we have minus 3. At the position of 1, here we have minus 1, that will be changed to 3 in this position. At the position of n is equal to 2, the amplitude is 2, it will be changed to minus 6 itself. This is the resultant signal. Next, we have the signal addition or signal subtraction. Let us explain it by the example itself. Consider a signal. Consider two signals, x1 of t and x2 of t. Here, this is the x1 of t signal. from 0 to t, x1 of t is equal to 2. Amplitude from the position of t is equal to 1 to 3, it will be a constant with a value of 1. From the position of 3 to 4, it is a constant with a value of 2. In case of the x2 of t signal, this continuous time signal consists of a linearly increasing graph from the position t is equal to 0 to t is equal to 1. From the position of t is equal to 1 to 3, we have a constant value of 1. From the position of t is equal to 3 to 4, there is a linear fall in the graph. So for the addition purpose, addition of x1 of t and x2 of t, first consider the case of in case 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1 position. Here x1 of t is equal to 2 and x2 of t is rising linearly from 0 to 1. That means x1 of t plus x2 of t will rise linearly from 2 plus 0 to position. That means the first position is 2 itself, and at the t is equal to 1 position, it is 2 plus 1, which is 3. So we have a linearly rising graph from 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1 position. In the second case, from 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3, this section here, first x1 of t is equal to 1 and x2 of t is also equal to 1. So 1 plus 1, we have 2 in this case. In the third position also, x1 of t is equal to 1 and x2 of t is also equal to 1. So up to between the point of 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3, we obtain a constant graph with a value of 2. Next, consider the section of 3 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 4. This section, in x1 of t, it is 2. The value is 2, while in case of x2 of t, the position 3 consists of a value 1. So 2 plus 1, it is 3. So x1 of t plus x2 of t graph will have a position of 3 in this case. By considering the fourth position here, x1 of t is equal to 2 and x2 of t is equal to 0. That means 2 plus 0, 2 itself. At the fourth position, we know that it is falling down to 0. Hence, the graph of x1 of t plus x2 of t will be obtained like this. In case of the subtraction of the same signals, that is from x1 of t minus x2 of t, let us consider just like this itself. First consider the 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1 case of both the signals. At here we know that x1 of t is equal to 2. Here x1 of t is equal to 0. 2 minus 0, it is 2 itself. So the first position is 2 itself. Next, at the 1 position, t is equal to 1 position, then it is x1 of t is equal to 2 and x2 of t is equal to 1. So 2 minus 1, we have 1 in this position. So we have a linearly falling graph from 2 to 1 during the interval of 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. As proved earlier, during the interval of 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3, it is a constant with a value of x1 of equal to 1 and x2 of equal to x2 of t also equal to 1. So 1 minus 1, we obtain 0 constant. At the position of this interval, that is 3 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 4, we have x1 of t equal to 2 at this point and x2 of t equal to 1 at this point. So 2 minus 1, we have 1 in this case. And at the position of 4, we have x1 of t equal to 2 and x2 of t is equal to 0. So 2 minus 0, 2 itself. So there we obtain a linearly increasing graph or a rise in the interval 3 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 4. And at the point of 4, we obtain 0. Consider the next discrete time example. Here we have the values as x1 of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 1, 5 and x2 of n is equal to 2, 4, minus 1, 3, 2. These arrowheads represent the n is equal to 0th position. By drawing the figures or graphically representing these discrete time signals, we obtain like this. From n is equal to minus 1 position, we have 1. N equal to 0th position, we have 2. N is equal to 1 position, we have 3. N is equal to 2 position, we have 1. N is equal to 3 position, we have 5. This is the x1 of n signal. And the second signal, x2 of n, can be obtained like this. From n is equal to minus 1, we have 2. N is equal to 0, we have 4. N is equal to 1, we have minus 1. N is equal to 2, we have 3. And n is equal to 3, we have 2. First, we are adding these two discrete time signals, x1 of n plus x2 of n. It will be useful by adding in this sequential representation itself. That is, x1 of n plus x2 of n will give y of n is equal to 3, 6, 2, 4, 7. And by representing that signal in the signal form, that is 2 plus 1 is equal to 3 in n minus 1, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6 in 0, minus 3 plus minus 1 is equal to 2 for n is equal to 1, 1 plus 3 is equal to 4 for n is equal to 2, and 5 plus 2 is equal to 7 for n is equal to 3. Now the second one is subtracting these two signals, y of n is equal to x1 minus x2 of n. X1 minus x2 of n will provide the value in the sequential format as minus 1, minus 2, 4, minus 2, 3. That means by physically representing the signal, graphically representing the signal, we obtain the graph like this. N is equal to minus 1, it is minus 1 itself. N is equal to 0, we have minus 2. N is equal to 1, we have 4. N is equal to 2, we have minus 2. And N is equal to 3, we have 3. The third operation is signal multiplication. An example signal is considered here with x1 of t and x2 of t. X1 of t signal is this. It is a continuous time signal. While the x2 of t signal is this. The multiplied signal x1 of t into x2 of t is obtained as y of t in this case. For finding out y of t, let us consider each interval separately. Consider the interval 0 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. Here, in case of x1 of t, the value is 2 and x2 of t is equal to 1. That is 2 into 1, we obtain 2 in this case. At the position of t equal to 1, here x1 of t is equal to 2 and x2 of t is equal to 1 itself. So 2 into 1, 2 itself. So it is a constant in the output. At the next, consider the interval. T is 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 2 in both x1 of t and x2 of t. In case of x1 of t, at the position of t equal to 1, x1 of t is equal to 1 and x2 of t at this position it is 1. 1 into 1, 1 is obtained in this case. In case of t is equal to 2, at the position here x1 of t will be equal to 1. And x2 of t is equal to 2 in this case. So 1 into 2, we obtain 2. At the t is equal to 2 position. At the t is equal to, in the next interval, that is 2 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 3, there is a linear fall in the x1 of t graph and a constant value of 2 in x2 of t graph. At the position of t is equal to 2, x1 of t is equal to 1 and x2 of t is equal to 2, so it is 2 itself. At the position of t is equal to 3, x1 of t is equal to 0 and x2 of t is equal to 2. So 0 into 2, it will always be 0 itself. So the x1 of t into x2 of t multiplication graph will be obtained as such. Next is an important property called time shifting property. If the continuous time signal represented by x of t is taken, then the output signal y of t is equal to x of t plus t. This represents that The signal is shifted to the left and it is an advanced version of the signal. Next is y of t is equal to x of t minus t. That is, it is shifted to the right and it is a delayed version of the x of t signal. Let us consider an example. This is the x of t value, where at the position of t is equal to minus 1, we have a value of 1. And then it remains constant between this time interval of minus 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 1. And from the position of 1 less than or equal to t less than or equal to 2, it is linearly falling in this case. So this x of t signal is first shifted. In the first case, we are taking y1 of t is equal to x of t minus 3. To find x of t minus 3, we are shifting these points to the right by 3. That is, at the position of minus 1 plus 3, we obtain 2. So the value of minus 1 will be drawn at the position of 2. And the remaining signals will be drawn as such. At the position of 0 plus 3, it is 3, 1 plus 3, 4, 2 plus 3, 5. The signal will be shifted to the right. This is a delayed signal. In case of a advanced signal, for example, consider y2 of t is equal to x of t plus 2. In this case, the signal is shifted to the left side of the graph. That means it is subtracted. At the position of minus 1 is shifted to the left by two position. First, second, here we have minus 1 position value. And the graph is drawn as such. Next is example of a discrete time signal, x of n, which is given as x of n equal to 1 for n is equal to minus 2, 2 for n is equal to minus 1, 3 for n is equal to 0, 2 for n is equal to 1, 1 for n is equal to 2, and 0 for both these cases. So by taking this signal, first it is shifted to the left by a delayed signal, y of n is equal to x of n minus 2. As it is shifted to the right by two position, to the right by two positions, from the position of n is equal to minus 2 plus 2 equals, at the position of n is equal to 0, we obtain the value of n is equal to minus 2. So it is, the signal is shifted just like that to the right. Similarly, we consider the advanced signal in this case also, where y of n is equal to x of n plus 3. It is shifted to the left side, and the value of x of n at the position of minus 2, it is minus 3 is considered. So minus 2, minus 3, minus 5. At n is equal to minus 5, we obtain y of n as such.